In our quest to learn about fire out west, we've been learning about the type of forest we've inherited over the last 100 years, based on the way we've worked with fire. Colin Hardy at the U.S. Forest Service helped explain it to us.
98% of new fire starts we put out before they're, you know, an acre or two. Every time we do that, we predispose the land to be sitting there longer, get more decadent, more dead and down, and so that when we do get a fire that we can't put out, we've handed that fire a vegetation and fuel complex that's never been out there before, so we're getting uncharacteristic fires because we're creating uncharacteristic fuel loads.
This message is something everyone has told us. It seems a big moral of the story is that we need more fire. In fact, it almost seems we should just let every fire burn. So we asked Colin, why can't we just do that?
Our moral obligation to human health is one reason why we can't. The smoke exposure over certain levels. So we have to balance what humans value versus how much they value the natural ecosystem. And we're trying to strike a balance. And we're moving in the right direction in being able to enable more fire.
So that's the dilemma. We do need more fire, but we also need a public that understands what they're trying to do, to get the forest back to where they were in recent history.
Historically, if fire were to run free, it would run into another old fire, which would run into another old fire. We would have had tens of thousands of patches out here that had 50 to 100 acre fires on them, and they would allow a fire to burn freely, but be confined and kind of redirected by all these other patches.
Not only would the fires in the past have been smaller, they'd have been very different. Now the fires are on the hundreds to half million acre size, and a fire like that isn't something this habitat has experienced before. Colin describes it as an uncharacteristic fire.
Uncharacteristic because it would burn more severely. There's more dense canopies, more fuel on the ground. It would pulse into the soil deeper, cause more damage to the organic layer. So in areas where we have critical infrastructure like a watershed, no matter how much we would like natural fire in there, it's really too much at risk. We could burn the organic layer down and then get erosion and flooding and those kinds of things. Had we kept up with the natural cycle of fire, then those uncharacteristic fires would be much less likely to happen. Now they're norm rather than the exception here in the last 15 to 20 years.
So even though we all know we need more fire, we can't just let it all burn. It's all about finding the balance and working with everyone to hopefully get our forests back to where they can tolerate more fire on them. Thanks for watching this episode, everyone. This is part of a whole series about the complexities of fire. Watch more via the links below.
Well, as we were filming, they had a fire, so they had to run.